leaving Portland Airport, going fishing to Alaska. Fishing poles. Gonna catch some sockeye, some pinks, get some red roe for bait, for eating those nice crepes with sour cream and salmon roe. All right, catch you on the water. Kenai River, Saldatna. People fishing. People flossing. People flipping. All kinds of stuff. We're looking for a spot to park the boat. I'm on the Kenai River. This is having a blast. I've been here for literally like working hard, like for 4 hours. I haven't caught a fish yet. Everybody else around me is catching fish. So you're standing in the water and you're whipping this whip thing, which is basically a hook, and it's got a bead on it to be legal, and you're literally snagging fish. Sometimes it falls at the fish's mouth. That's how they call this, flossing and flipping. So this group over here with probably guides and stuff, that's to my left. They're catching fish here and there. This is my friend, his crew. Lots of people from Portland area catching lots of fish, kids and little kids, and 9-year-old and younger. They've been to Alaska like literally multiple, 5-6 times. They love it here, catching a lot of fish. This is Kenai River. I have not eaten today other than whatever Dimitri gave me, which a couple of crackers. I didn't want to miss any moment of this, and my waders leaked. I was filled up with water up to my ass, and all the stuff that's between the leg and the wader was filled up with water. So literally I was like, on each leg I had like, you know, 5 to 10 gallons of water, cold water, carrying it, right? You know, like I couldn't even lift my leg. Anyway, I hope I catch some fish today. If not, I'm gonna be fishing at night, all night if I have to, darn it. All right, back to flossing or flipping, whatever they call locals here call. One last view of life in the river here. It's lots of fun.
Good morning. It's early morning, 7 a.m. Woke up half an hour ago. Cam in Saldatna, Alaska, where people have the small cabins for, you know, bunk beds and 3, 4, 5 people, really small. There's no running water. They have to bring their water. No gas. The only thing that they have was electric, a dumpster, and a portable potty. Tiny buckets. Yesterday was a total fiasco. I landed 0 fish. I had like 10 come off, maybe a little bit less than 10. My rod was medium, and for this water, you have to have heavy rod. So when you're flipping or flossing, those are terms used around here. So I'm headed down to the island that we could have access to on foot with no boat. And then after Dimitri wakes up, maybe he'll take us to the other spot. We'll see. And today is Saturday, so it's gonna be busy with the guides and stuff. So we'll take our chances this morning. It kind of sucks going back without having to catch any fish yourself, and people are just offering to give me like, here's 6 fish, let's go home, we're tired, let's just give you 6 fish, would you please take it? I'm like, and then my cousin in Anchorage is like, come back early on Monday to Vasila, so hang out. instead of fishing all day, I'll give you the fish. Friends and relatives. Okay, I'll see you in the water and wish me luck.
So officially the curse has been lifted. This is my first Kenai River sockeye caught in the head. After 2 days of fishing, it's a nice fish, big. I mean, there are bigger, but this is nice. It's on the small side, but just right here. Anyway, thanks for watching. And thank you, fish, for being caught. You're gonna be really appreciated. Again, it's the flipping or the flossing.
Hey, my second sockeye. It's bigger than the first one. Today's just still starting. It's only about 11:20 in the morning. We're gonna take a break and come back in the evening. But this is a beauty. Mwah. Really hefty. Oh, man. Compared to my fist, look at that. The head. Oh, that's not me bleeding, it's the fish. Thank you. Stay tuned for more.
Later on today, evening fishing, I caught two reds and one pink. Pretty tired right now. It's about only 8 p.m. Alaska time, 9 p.m. Portland time. I think I'm gonna hit the sack and get up early, maybe at 4. And go fishing, go for it, catch my limit. And I'm also thinking about staying in Alaska for a few more days. Oh no, I know, that's crazy. I shouldn't do that. I should make a video about that, but that's what I'm thinking. My host, Dimitri, doesn't seem to mind. He's very open-hearted, welcoming, friendly, accommodating gentleman, and his wife and his family. And I'm just staying in my van. I have everything I need, water. I have a stove. All I need is some electricity to freeze the fish. And really I can stay away from anybody's way. That's an interesting way to approach Alaska fishing, like especially during this hot season for sockeye. You can really come here, you can really just fly over to Anchorage, rent a car, or you could fly to Soldotna for $120 with like Raven Airlines, and you could get a car here if you want. Or just get one at the Anchorage Airport. Either way. Then you can find a place to camp. And when the fish is coming on strong, you are like, every time you cast, you're bound to catch a fish. Every other cast, every third, fifth, you know, fifth or sixth cast, everybody's catching, everybody's busy. Yeah, it's crazy. So that's when you come during those crazy times. How do you know? You have to watch the fish count. I will try to, so like yesterday and today we had a count of 24,000. So for it to be worthwhile, it has to be, you know, 100,000, four times more for anybody to come, you know, to really like just catch and think, you know, you're doing good. Catch, and go home. If it's not like over 100,000, you know, fish coming through, then it's more difficult. Yes, can you do the limit, which is 6? Yes, you can. Department can limit the fish to 3 or 2. They can do that. They could impose emergency fishing, which means commercial fisher boats, fishing boats will come out and fish at most of the day and most of the night. And there'll be very little that's gonna, salmon's gonna sneak through. So, anyway, I'm thinking about reshooting this video because I'm so tired. My face looks so tired.
But at least this will remind me about the things that have happened during this time and what I wanted to mention that I think would be useful for you guys. Thank you so much.
Another day in the Kenai River near Soldotna. And today was the most successful day. We caught, Andre and I caught this fish. I got six. We got two. I got the biggest ones. So, yeah. Today at 5:30, I was on the water at 6. A lot of them came off, like 6 or 7. I had a problem with the first eyelet. Oh, here, there's a fish. We're gonna go get it. We're gonna try to film his reeling. Just I'm afraid to drop the phone. So, but yeah, he's giving a big fight. I'm gonna put the phone away. I better.